It is Universal Century 0079, January 3rd. The Principality of Zeon has declared war against the Earth Federation government. At the time, I was a mobile suit pilot, but injuries I had received during the first battle forced me to retire from my duties. I then proposed to form a special task force consisting of mobile suits, codenamed Midnight Fenrir Unit, which received approval and was sent into combat missions under my leadership. March 11th, the second Earth descent operation had begun. Captain Garma Zabi was the commander in charge of conquering the North American territory.
I'm honored to have such outstanding soldiers under my command and to be in charge of capturing the North American territory. We will conquer North America to establish a base from which we can move to take over Jaburo, the Federation's general headquarters in South America.
Our first mission was to secure an airbase as a beachhead for the invasion of the North American region. Next, we breached the powerful defense line of California Base. We used an underground waterway discovered during the battle and snuck into the enemy facilities on our own. Finally, we succeeded in taking over California Base. Our forces landed all around the Earth and took over numerous territories at lightning speed. However, we had expanded the battle lines so quickly, we were unable to send enough supplies to all those front lines and failed to advance our forces any further. We believed the Federation forces could not put up any organized resistance, as our offenses had inflicted considerable damage. Still, we had to guard against potential guerrilla warfare on our forces' undermanned battle lines. With neither side able to deal the decisive blow to defeat the other, the war remained at a stalemate. During this tense standoff, the Federation forces were developing mobile suits of their own that would rival ours.
Reporting. The Zakus I had sent out on a scout mission were engaged in a battle against a Federation mobile suit in Side 7. We lost two of our Zakus to just one Federation mobile suit. We will continue pursuing their V project.
If you know about the Federation's V project and their prototype mobile suits, you'll be pleased that I'm zeroing in on them.
What's that?
However, Captain, it has also cost me 8 Zakus to find and eventually corner them.
Extraordinary. You sure it was worth it?
I forced them into your vicinity. You can score some brownie points off them.
The official name given to the new battleship we've dubbed the Trojan Horse is Pegasus-class assault carrier battleship White Base, and the one we've been referring to as the White Mobile Suit is called the Gundam. This machine holds a high-output beam rifle and beam saber, and bullets from the Zaku machine gun have no effect on it.
Maybe the Red Comet's right after all. Compared to the other Federation ships I fought against in the past, this particular one looks like a real beast.
The Trojan Horse had evaded Commander Shar and descended into the North American region. It then survived repeated attacks by Captain Garma. The mission given to our unit was to search for the Trojan Horse along with the mobile suits it carried. We had been informed that the Trojan Horse was hiding in the S3 point. However, a tragedy occurred before we were able to locate the enemy ship.
The mobile suit is running away. The Trojan Horse should be right up ahead. Hurry!
Yes, Shark. Hey, Garma, you read me? Blame this on the misfortune of your birth.
Don't take it personally. You can thank your father.
You double-cross me, Shark! I'm a son of the Zabi family. I'll go down with honor! Glory to the Principality of Zeon!
We have lost a true hero to our glorious and noble cause, but are we defeated? No! For us, this is a new beginning. It's been over 50 years since the elite of Earth, consumed by greed, took control of the Earth Federation. Our citizens have seen nothing but oppression. We want our freedom.
Never forget the times when the Federation has trampled us. We, the Principality of Zeon, have had a long and arduous struggle to achieve freedom. Our fight is sacred. Our cause divine. My beloved brother Garmazavi was sacrificed. Why?
The spoiled brat.
The war is at a stalemate. Garma has opened your eyes to the blinding truth of your complacency.
We are finally in a position where victory is within our grasp. Zeon thirsts for the strength of its people. Once again, our most cherished nation will flourish. Victory is the greatest tribute we can pay those who have sacrificed their lives for us. Hail Zeon!
Hail Zeon!
Trojan horse broke through our siege and headed for the Asian territory. Lieutenant Romba Rawl was appointed to avenge the late Vice Admiral Garmazavi.
Found something interesting?
Sir, I've discovered an unlisted warship, so I'm unable to classify it.
Amon, I'm off.
That thing is different. It's got more armor and more power than a Zaku.
This is no Zaku, boy. No Zaku. You fought splendidly, but now you'll see the ultimate fate that awaits true warriors. Watch closely.
The loss of this legendary warrior was a shock to the Zeon forces. November 7th, Odessa. At the request of Captain Makuve, we had left the supply base in the Gobi Desert to provide support for our forces in Odessa. We were dispatched to a brutal front line to face the enemy's main forces.
Ortega and Mash, we're gonna pull a jet stream attack and not in our mobile suit! Hey! I ain't no goddarn springboard!
Black Tri-Stars would never make it back to the front line. Though the fierce battle raged on around us, we were assigned to guard the Zanzibar spaceship until Captain Makuve could depart safely aboard the ship.
If they want it that badly, we'll hand it over to them. We've already mined all the resources we need from the area. Odessa no longer has any strategic value to us. The Federation has most certainly initiated a useless battle, Your Excellency.
The Mad Angler Squadron, headed by Captain Char, was pursuing the Trojan Horse.
Reporting from the Mad Angler Squadron, Spy 107 has managed to sneak aboard the Trojan Horse and has informed us that their destination is Jaburo.
Our forces gathered as much military power as possible and were about to invade Jaburo. However, the battle ended with our forces having to retreat. The next stage of the battle took place in outer space. The tide of the war had been completely reversed. We watched as the Federation forces gathered in Solomon.
Get how a single mobile suit could do this! You will not beat me! You will not beat me!
Char, you're finished!
The Gundam even defeated the famous Newtype Corps.
Voila!
There is no other way for mankind to last forever except by living under our direct control. We are the chosen. We are the superior race of Zeon.
December 31st, the Zeon forces took on the Federation fleet at the final defense line. Our soldiers were pitted against a formidable enemy. Each came from a different background, and each fought for a different personal reason, and many lost their lives. The Principality of Zeon was defeated. However, as long as there are comrades who continue to fight for their beliefs, kindled by their love for those on the home front, our own battle will likely never end.